In this video, I will show you step by step how to install and run Kali Linux 2024 on Windows 11 with GUI using WSL. We will start by enabling Windows Subsystem for Linux and show you how to download and install Kali Linux 2024. Additionally, I will show you how to run Linux GUI applications natively alongside Windows 11. By the end of this video, you will be able to unlock the potential of WSL, allowing you to run a full Kali desktop environment seamlessly. Let's get started. To use WSL, ensure that the hardware virtualization feature is enabled. This feature is enabled by default on most computers. If it's not enabled, you need to access your BIOS settings and enable the Intel VT-D, AMD-V or SVM feature. To verify the hardware virtualization on your Windows computer, open Task Manager, select the CPU tab and check the virtualization status. If it's enabled, you are good to go. Before setting up WSL, if your computer has a dedicated GPU like NVIDIA or AMD, it's recommended to install the latest drivers to enable GPU acceleration. Then open the search bar, type Turn Windows Features and select this option. Now look for the virtual machine platform and enable it. Then look for the Windows subsystem for Linux and enable it. Then click on Apply to turn on these features and reboot your Windows computer to apply the changes. After rebooting, right-click on the desktop, open the terminal, and type this command to update WSL to the latest version. Once it's done, type WSL --version to see the version information of WSL, WSLG, and Linux kernel. It's time to install Kali Linux. First, clear the console by typing cls. If you type WSL, you will see that there are no installed Linux distributions. To list available Linux distros, type WSL --list --online. You will see a list of distros available for installation. Look for Kali Linux and install it by typing WSL --install -D. Then specify the distro name and press Enter to start the installation. This may take some time depending on your internet connection speed. Once it's done, enter the username, making sure to type in lowercase and then set a password. Now keep in mind, when you are typing a password, it will not be displayed for security reasons. And voila, now you can see the prompt has changed and we are inside the Kali Bash environment. Now you will see it runs the latest Kali Linux 2024. Let me go ahead and close the terminal. The great thing about running Kali on Windows 11 using WSL, you can run the Kali Bash directly by searching for it in the Start menu. If you open the Start menu, Kali is available as a part of the Windows applications. Now let's go to the Windows terminal and type this command to set Kali as the default Linux distribution. This way you can open command prompt or PowerShell in Windows and type WSL to access the Kali Bash environment. This is a CLI version of Kali and you can use it to run servers like Casa OS, Umbrel, and many more. Now go ahead and type the following command to update Kali Linux. Using apt, you can install packages like NeoFetch or htop, and you can see it works fine without any issues. Now let's try running Linux GUI applications. I'm going to install Qt Text Editor and GIMP. As you can see, if I execute GIMP, it uses GPU to render the user interface and loads much faster than ever before. All these powerful GUI applications open instantly without any issues. This is incredible. I am impressed with the WSLG performance on Windows 11. It's getting much better. To see the list of Linux GUI applications, open the Start menu, and you will see a Kali Linux group has been created. Now inside this group, you will see all the installed applications. You can even pin them to the taskbar. This way, you can run Linux applications alongside Windows applications seamlessly. As a bonus part of this video, let's set up a GUI desktop environment for Kali Linux. We're going to install XFCE, which is a lightweight graphical user interface. To set up the XFCE desktop, open the Kali bash and run this command to set up Kali KEX tools. Then type kex dash dash win and set the password. Now this will start the kex server, and in a moment kex client will be triggered, and voila, now you can see Kali desktop. You can press F8 to bring up the contextual menu. Using this, you can disconnect from KEX server, disable full screen, and much more. Now, as you can see, we are running the latest XFCE desktop environment. You can see all of the GUI applications are working fine. I have installed Chrome as a dev package and it works with no issues. To disable the GUI environment, press F8 and click on Disconnect. The KEX server will run in the background and help to reconnect to the GUI environment using this command. When you are done working with the GUI desktop, you can stop the KEX server by typing this command. To relaunch the GUI desktop, you can type this command. And lastly, by default, Kali Linux on WSL comes with minimal package installation. To set up the full edition of Kali Linux, you can run this command to install all recommended packages. Now, this includes all tools in Kali plus some additional packages. It may take some time, so please be patient. And that's pretty much it. This is how you can install Kali Linux 2024 on Windows 11 using WSL. With the help of WSLG, you can easily run Linux desktop and GUI applications. What do you guys think about it? If you have any questions or queries, do post them in the comment section down below. I will try to help you. Thank you so much for watching. This has been KSK Royal. I will see you in the next one.